Hi, I'm Jeff Shire, owner of Mattress To Go, and today I want to talk to you a little bit about Innersprings, their design, construction, and some of the more popular ones that are out there in the industry today. Innersprings really first started to become popular back in the late 1800s. They're actually derivatives of the springs used for the seat cushions in the buggies that were drawn by horses. And the one that's sort of the granddaddy of the industry is the hourglass-shaped spring, or the Bonel innerspring unit. And you can see it is hourglass-shaped in design, wider on the top, thinner cylindrical body in the center. On the top, it's knotted. This is just called a knotted spring design right here. While we're taking a look at this, let's go over some of the features of a typical innerspring design. The lacing that holds the springs together is called helical lacing, and that's just there to keep the springs in a proper orientation. And then usually around the perimeter of the innerspring unit, you'll find a thick steel border rod. Again, this lends solidity to the innerspring unit and also helps to keep the springs in a proper orientation. Now, all innerspring units will come in different diameters and sizes and thicknesses of steel. We'll talk about that in another video. I know you can't wait for that. The Bonel innerspring unit begat what's called an offset innerspring unit. And this is a typical offset design. What an offset spring is you see this flat part right here on the top and the bottom where it locks into the helical lacing. This is called an offset. And this is supposed to allow the spring basically to pivot a little bit better and sense and respond more appropriately to your body. You can see that this type of a spring design is still knotted on top, just like the Bonel spring we looked at a second ago. Now, from the knotted innerspring unit, we came up with what's called an LFK, or a Luraflex innerspring unit. Here's a typical design of one of those. And what happened is we eliminated the knotted part of the innerspring unit right here. And this is what's called an open-ended sensory arm construction. You can see it's still offset on the top and the bottom so that it hinges well. But then this part is allowed to free float, and this allows for the spring, in theory, to better sense and respond to your body's weight. This is a bit of a larger diameter unit. We also have one right here. That's a smaller diameter LFK spring unit. You can see just smaller springs, higher spring count. Again, the open-ended sensory arm on top, the helical lacing holding all the springs together in proper orientation. Again, the theory here is more springs going to sense and respond to your body just a little bit better. Now, there's a different type of spring unit that many people are familiar with. They've seen the commercials on television with a bowling ball that drops on the pins, you know, years and years ago. And that's called a Marshall coil, or what you're probably better known as, what you've probably seen it on television, is a pocketed coil innerspring unit. Now, Mr. Marshall developed this back in 1900, hence the name, and this is basically a spring and a sock. There's a spring inside each of these fabric compartments right here, and basically these are made into rows, and then instead of being held together with a helical lacing, these rows are actually glued together. The fabric is glued together to hold these springs in place and to keep them in proper alignment. Some of these innerspring units will have a border rod around the perimeter, some of them won't. The theory behind a Marshall coil unit is that it's allowed to flow even more freely than the Bonel or the LFK springs that we looked at a second ago, again, to better sense and respond to your body. Some people prefer that, some people don't. Now, the last major type of innerspring unit that's out there is what's called a continuous coil. As the name implies, it's not really a true innerspring unit, but it's a coil. It's one piece of wire that's woven into a grid network, and this is just a long continuous row of coils that act as individual springs, but it's actually, it goes the entire length of the mattress. These individual rows of coils are held together by helical lacing, just like the hourglass-shaped spring. And the theory behind a continuous coil unit is that while it still acts as an innerspring unit, still senses and responds, it maintains a bit more of a flat profile on top, and this allows the bed to keep a bit more of a flat nature, allows for less body impressioning. So these are the major types of innerspring units that are featured in our industry these days. In our next video, we're going to go over the differences in these units as far as the number of springs, the thickness of the steel, zoning of the innerspring units, different edge support systems, all the things to look at to consider when you're looking at a mattress to purchase for yourself. Thanks for watching.